Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. It seems like every movie or story involving someone in a near-death experience has their life flashing before their eyes, or a light at the end of the tunnel calling to them. Pretty literary tropes aside, what do people really see during near-death experiences? And why? A near-death experience, or NDE, is a significant psychological event that can occur when a person is close to death or in other situations of physical or emotional crisis. NDEs can vary from person to person, but common elements of the phenomenon can include seeing a bright light or lights, strong emotions, having an out-of-body experience, and seeing religious figures or deceased friends and family. And if you ask the OA and Homer, near-death experiences can also lead to some unique dance moves. Can season 2 just come out already? So why do people have near-death experiences? Are they seeing some form of afterlife? Are they talking to a god or some greater celestial being? While it can be very difficult to confirm or deny religious or spiritual beliefs on topics like this, we can look into the science behind it. It seems as though near-death experiences might have to do with a person's temporal lobe. When looking at temporal lobe functioning in individuals who reported having near-death experiences, they were found to have more types of significant temporal lobe activity than control subjects, and they also reported significantly more temporal lobe epileptic symptoms. The studies also found that the near-death experiences had shorter sleep durations and delayed REM sleep when compared to the control group. Potentially furthering a correlation between the human brain and near-death experiences, another recent study found that NDEs were uncommon in head injury cases compared to other near-death conditions. Only 3 of the 86 recruited head injury patients had a clear and confident experience of an NDE. It's also interesting to point out that the reports from all 3 of the NDE-positive individuals were rich in descriptions of light visions from their experience. Many people also express heightened senses during near-death experience, and that it somehow felt realer than real. Curious as to why this was, researchers found in a recent smaller study that NDE memories have more phenomenological characteristics than memories of imagined and real events. Since imagined events have, on average, less of these characteristics than real event memories, these findings were quite intriguing. They suggest that NDE memories may not simply be imagined event memories, but rather that their psychological origins could lead them to be truly perceived, even if they are not lived in reality. So why do so many people talk about a bright light at the end of a tunnel? It seems like this could be due to a person's blood and oxygen flow being depleted to their eyes at the time of their NDE. It can be common in near-death experiences for a person to lose blood or lack an adequate amount of oxygen. One or both of these things have the potential to lead to tunnel vision, possibly explaining the light at the end of the tunnel that is always talked about. Have you ever had an NDE? What was it like? Let me know in the comment section below, or tell us, what should we talk about next? Make sure you come back every Monday for a brand new video, and if you want to know just how important the first years of your life are, then you should definitely check out this episode of Life Noggin. The power of recognition also dramatically shoots up, tied to significant growth occurring in the hippocampus. Every time I say hippocampus, I always think about a bunch of hippos going to college, and it makes me smile. My name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.